Hello everybody, it is Shard, GVRP here, back again with a new video on the channel, guys. So today I am actually going to be going through things that I miss in Greenville. So basically I'm going to be going through things that used to exist in Greenville but no longer do exist. And I'm basically just going to be going through some of the things that I think should be, like, should come back into the game. And I think would be really cool for them to implement back into the game. A lot of these things, in fact, I'm pretty sure all of these things, mainly, have all came from GV3. So, yeah, a lot of the stuff was removed in, like, the revamp. So, yeah, but anyways, let's get into the video. Also, guys, if you do land up enjoying this video, please make sure to drop a like and subscribe if you haven't already. It would really mean a lot to me and help me out. So, yeah, thank you guys so much. But, yeah, so the first thing that I want to get into is rain. So, for those of you who don't know, GV3 actually used to have rain. And I know that may sound quite weird because GV4 doesn't have any type of weather system at all, but GV3 actually did have a rain system. So basically every once in a while in game, it would sometimes rain and stuff like that, like sort of like Southwest Florida, how they have it. And it was just a lot more realistic and better in my opinion. And yeah, it overall was just really cool. And yeah, because like it's obviously it's good to have it always being sunny and stuff like that, but just for like realism purposes and stuff like that, it would be really cool if there could actually be some rain and stuff like that, or just the weather system in general. Like, also because of the fact that, like, let's say there's like a tornado RP, you can't really make it rain anymore in GV4, because even though the admins can activate the tornado sirens, like it can't actually rain, I guess you could say. So it's a bit more unrealistic than it would be if you could rain. So, if the game could rain. So, yeah, I really do think they should add that back. I don't exactly know when they would, if they are going to. Alrighty, guys, so we have actually now made it into GV3. It is quite dark right now. But, yeah, it's going to become day pretty soon. But, yeah, so this is, like, around the time. This is what GV kind of looked like around the time when I actually started playing it. So, it does look quite a lot different. The dealership is a lot smaller. The parking lot is very small compared to how it is now. And there's just overall not as much things. But, yeah, so, as you can see, you have, like, different, like, GUIs and stuff. I'm just going to drive around in this Toyota Matrix, I guess, since it was already in my inventory. But, yeah, so let's get in this thing. And, yeah, so anyways, let's drive around here. So the first thing that I want to get into, I guess, in GV3 is the fact that a lot of cars actually had interiors. So as you can see in this car, at least there is an interior. Of obviously it is a little bit broken, probably one because this car is like old, and also two just because it wasn't that good of a car, to be honest. But yeah, just for an example, like this car, it's sort of like Pembroke Pines in a way. They had like basic interiors and stuff like that, even in non-convertible cars. And I honestly really, really like that feature. I don't think they're ever going to bring it back like nowadays, just because of the fact that they don't want the game to lag any more than it already does. And also just because of the fact that it will take way too long for them to kind of just like fit interiors into every single car that's in the game currently. But this is definitely a feature that I miss though, and if they could ever bring it back, then I would love to see it come back, but I don't think it will, unfortunately. But yeah, it's just something cool to think about, I guess. And man, am I the only one that misses like all of these houses down this road? I just feel like there was something different about this neighborhood that made it feel more like homey, I guess you could say. Like it felt a lot, it looked a lot better in my opinion. I mean, I wouldn't say it looks better, but there's just something about it that kind of made it, you know, really good in my opinion. So now we're actually moving on to the campsite. So a lot of OG Greenville players will probably remember the campsite back in GV3. This place used to be very, very good for roleplaying, and it was actually really, really fun. The main reason why they removed it from my knowledge, though, is due to all of the trees. But the thing is that I'm pretty sure in GV4, they actually, like, remodeled all the trees to be not as laggy anymore. So, I don't really know, but yeah, I'm pretty sure that was the main reason why they actually removed the campsites later on down the line. But yeah, as you can see, we're driving up here on this, like, dirt track. And, yeah, so there's actually a campsite down here. So, as you can see, you have, like, some tents, you have, like, barbecues, you have tables and chairs, and you have, like, a massive fire, like, campfire. And also, you have, like, a volleyball court net thingy. So, yeah, I don't think you can actually... Oh, wait, can you? Okay, I think you might have been able to pick up the ball, but I think it's, like, broken nowadays, which is sad, but hey, it's whatever. As you can see, I'm sitting down, it's also a little bit broken, but hey, this version of the game is very outdated, so it's expected to be kind of broken. But yeah, and then also you have, like, these, like, beds and stuff, and then you got the tent. It's really nice overall. It was just a really nice, like, chill RP spot, I guess you could say, and I really do miss it, but I do understand why they probably won't be bringing it back anytime soon, except it would be very cool. Like, I'm hoping that when the Park Ranger update comes out, they do, like, add something like this back. I feel like it would make a lot of sense. I just don't know how they would implement it to make it not lag. Alright guys, so for this next thing that I miss in Greenville, I am actually going to have to change my job to be a WSP officer. So as you can see, if I click State Patrol, I don't know if it teleports me. Okay, no, it doesn't actually teleport me like how it does in GB4. So I guess that means that I am going to have to drive over there, but except I'm actually going to drive over to spawn first because I've actually loaded into my alt account so then I can actually show you guys what I am going to show you guys. All right, so I'm having a little bit of a problem here. My boy Dominic Toretto can't actually get into my car because it doesn't have seats. So that's a bit of a problem. I think I'm going to have to go buy a new car that actually has seats in it. All right, guys, so good news. This car actually has two seats. So I'm actually going to be driving it on my alt account. I'm actually driving it from my other monitor at the moment, so it's probably going to be a bit laggy. Actually, I just remembered that you can... Actually, no, can you steal cars? Let's see. I don't think I can. I think it just jumps me out. Yeah, it just ejects me, actually. So no, I can't actually steal cars, unfortunately. It's a bit unfortunate, but hey, I guess that's just how it's going to have to work. But yeah, so as you guys can see, there's also some, like, rain clouds coming out, which is pretty cool. They don't look the best, if I'm going to be honest, but at least there's actually some sort of, like, you can tell that it might rain soon. So we'll hope that it starts raining soon, so then I can show you guys an example of, like, the weather system, I guess you could say. But yeah, let's just drive over to the WSP station right here, which you guys will also see looks very different to how it now looks. Like, this is giving me so much flashbacks, though, from back when I used to play GV3. I honestly, I don't know why, but I found GV3 a lot more fun. GV4 is obviously way better in general, but I don't know, there's just something about GV3 that, in my opinion, was a lot better. Also, another thing is, like, the trees. I wish they added all these trees back. Like, there's so much trees to the point where you can't even see through, like, that part. But I'm gonna be honest here, I was actually a massive fan of the trees in this game. They looked really nice in my opinion, and it overall just made the aesthetic of the game a lot better. Alright guys, so as you can see here, we are rolling up on the old fire station and the old WSP station. So as you can see, both of them look really, really different, including mainly the police station. In my opinion, at least, the police station looks the most different out of the fire station and the WSP station. It is a lot smaller. And yeah, this is just giving me so much flashbacks, dude. I remember when it looked like this. Obviously, the new one is so much better, but yeah, this is just giving me a lot of flashbacks. So as you can see, these are like the old prison cells, and I like how they were actually animated. I wish they were still animated like that, because they did look pretty cool. And also, even this bed, how it's like hanging off by chains, that looks really cool. But yeah, anyways, let me actually figure out where I actually get my equipment, because this has been a while. I don't know how I get through, though. That's the thing. Okay, there we go. It just opened up for me. So, this is, like, the old uniform, I guess. I don't think this button works anymore. Yeah, I don't think it actually works. So, that's pretty weird. Hopefully, these tools still work. Okay, so the tools actually work. So, I do really miss, like, these old toolbar GUI thingies, how they were all, like, rounded and stuff. I actually like these a lot better than the current ones. So yeah, but anyways, the thing that I'm actually gonna be getting into is the handcuffs. So for those of you who don't know, in GV3, the handcuffs actually worked. So when GV4 came out, the handcuffs just, like, stopped working, and I think they just did it on purpose so then, like, cops and public servers didn't abuse their permissions and stuff like that. But the thing is that if they do hopefully still work, as you can see, I actually can't handcuff him. And that's because he's not on the criminal team. So if I go onto my alt account and change my team to criminal, so now the name is red, as you can see, then I should just be able to click. I don't actually know if it still works, but back in the day, it did work really good. So they would, like, not be able to escape from your cuffs, I guess. I don't actually think it works anymore, though. That's kind of weird. So I'm honestly just assuming that the tool, like, the handcuff tool has broken, except it actually did used to work, and you would be able to, like, they would basically, like, be stuck to your handcuffs and you could, like, move them around and stuff as long as they were on the criminal team. So yeah, I really hope they bring back that soon, because nowadays, like, it's just a lot more unrealistic when you're handcuffing people, and I just really hope that they do land up fixing it sometime soon. But I feel like Greenville should add back some of the trees and stuff like that, because nowadays, yeah, they do still have trees, but they just aren't as much as they used to be. And I feel like I don't know why I'm like always talking about the trees in Greenville, but I feel like the trees back in like GV3 gave the game such a good vibe to it, and it low-key just suited the entire map and stuff like that a lot more. But I do understand why they probably removed him, which is probably lag issues and stuff like that. But if they could like do it, like find a way how to do it without making the game lag too much, then like that would be so good, because like it just made the entire scenery of the map and stuff like that a lot better than it currently is. Because right now it's kind of just, in GV4 at least, it's kind of just full grass. Like this road, for example, it's just all grass and there's like no trees or anything. That's kind of what GV4 is like now, and it just doesn't look as good as GV3. All right guys, and now the last thing that I'm going to be moving on to is the racetrack. So a lot of you OGs who used to like race in your Lamborghini Gallardos will definitely remember this thing from back in the day. So it is understandable why they removed this thing, because they probably replaced it due to the airport. And the airport is basically just a bigger, like, sort of drag strip, I guess you could say. But this, like, actually was really cool, because it actually had, like, a thing. So if you did start in chat, hopefully it still works. Oh, it actually still works, surprisingly. So as you can see, like, I can't actually move until it turns green, and then it lets me drive off, but you have to say start in the chat, and then it actually lets you drive off and drag race. Now in my opinion, that's a lot better, because it makes it so like everyone starts at the same time, and it's not kind of like all like uneven and stuff like that, and people start at the wrong times and stuff like that. I feel like this was just a lot better. I do think that they should make, I think in the later versions of GV3, they actually extended the length of the drag strip, because I don't remember it really being that short. But yeah, I don't think they ever will add this back due to them having the airport in the game now. But yeah, that's just another thing that I kind of miss. But yeah, anyways guys, that's going to wrap it up for today's video. Again, if you haven't already and you did enjoy the video, please make sure to like and subscribe if you haven't already. And yeah, anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and yeah, see you later guys, and goodbye.